All right, hello and welcome back, everybody, to our next episode of Craic, and we're going to be talking about today. Technology is going to be our main topic, and again, we're going to try to keep it generalized, and it's such a broad topic, you know. Yeah. So we're not going to get too specific into anything today, but we do have some other stories and stuff that we want to bring up and talk about. But this is definitely a topic we can come back to and revisit, right?
Mm-hmm, definitely.
There's tons of stuff to talk about. I know you got a lot of things that you want to share. And so for this first segment of our show, we're going to talk a little bit about the progression of technology in our lives. Mm-hmm. So Michael, do you have, when you were a kid and growing up and stuff, like what were some of the huge differences that you can see now in like technology?
So, I mean, when I was a kid, we didn't spend as much time, you know, hanging around technology and stuff like that, because we would, you know, go outside and do things instead of staying inside. But
that's a huge difference, right?
that's a big difference.
I think so.
One bad thing about technology.
I think some of the most technologically advanced things in our lives were like computers and video games, right? Like nothing else.
At least that we could kind of visually see, because, you know, those are kind of the things that we interact with every day.
Right.
I don't really know as much about like cars, you know, or innovations in cars.
Back then, as kids, like we didn't have that interaction with phones and stuff like that, like kids do now, right? Every kid you see has a phone of some kind. So
I don't think I got my first phone until I was almost in high school or in high school.
Yeah,
I don't remember. So I was like 13, 14 probably when I got a phone.
Yeah, it was just a regular flip phone probably, right?
Yeah, just normal phone. It wasn't, I never had the fortune of having one of those big ones.
Did you ever use it even?
No, probably not. It was pretty much, you know, for like emergencies. Yeah, like call my mom. Like, where are you? Why didn't you pick me up today? But, so that's kind of like the main thing that I have seen.
We didn't
evolve.
Have technology like integrated with our childhoods like kids do these days.
Yeah.
And especially with like even some of the toys. Like some of the toys you have as kids that we would used to play with would be like Matchbox cars or something.
Yeah.
Or action figures or something. Mm-hmm. And
or like Legos and stuff like that.
Now everything these days though is
has to move or has to interact.
It has to move by itself. It's got to have some kind of batteries in it or something, right?
Remote control.
So that's definitely very interesting how that's progressed over time. But I think even other things like transportation, the healthcare, and what was the other one? Physical science we're talking about. Those are some of the different areas in technology that we've also seen some progression in. Even in cars, you can see a lot of the upgrades that are done to cars nowadays.
Mm-hmm.
You know, all cars still have cup holders. That's still like the main thing that you need for a car, right, is a cup holder. But there's a lot of different things. Like we never used to have the flip down video display or whatever where you could watch movies and stuff, right? Like that's something you have in every van, every minivan, you know. If you have kids, that's something you gotta have in your car. Is that flip down.
Or like my friend has this thing where she just waves her foot in front of her trunk and it opens for her.
Really?
Which is kinda weird.
Wow.
I don't know.
So like
why?
If you're holding a bunch of groceries or
something,
yeah,
you can just wave your leg and the trunk will open for you.
I never heard of that before.
Or she also doesn't have to use keys or anything. She just has her keys in her pocket, and when she walks up to the car, it opens for her, and the car starts, which is really
convenient.
That's convenient. I don't know like how necessary you need some of these things because it's kind of weird, but
yeah,
I mean it's nice.
Some technology is born out of necessity. Other technology is just because.
Yeah.
Just because we can.
Yeah,
America,
some of it is.
Right?
A lot of it's kind of unnecessary. Like I was looking at this thing the other day about paper towel dispensers.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Have you ever had a problem with like just the normal paper towel dispensers where you just pull it out?
Such a pain.
Yeah, now you have to like wave your hand and like.
Man. That's horrible. Gosh.
Just making things worse.
I really wish technology was better, man. That's just terrible to have to go through that. But, it's funny to think back on how that's all changed from being, like, something that's really and truly improving our lives to something that's just there for no apparent reason other than to, you know, make it slightly faster, easier, mm-hmm. you know. Like, every new, like, electronic that comes out is all just about being a little bit faster by a hair, by better. 1 megabyte or something, mm-hmm. you know. Everything's just a little bit better now, you know.
Yeah. I remember when they came out with the, I think it was like the Apple II computer, where it was the first one where it was just like the dome box that connected to the monitor. And I kind of freaked out because I was always used to having this big monitor, like the tube monitors with the big box. And it was kind of, you know, cool to me to have all of that integrated into one thing. And that was the first time that I was really impressed with technology, probably. Because that was like, I didn't understand how they went from this big bulky thing to this very small, you know, portable, kind of portable for the time.
Exactly.
And that to me was impressive. Since then, I haven't been too impressed with many things. I mean, you know, going from Discman to kind of iPods was pretty big also.
Yeah, music has definitely taken a bunch of leaps and bounds in their technology with sound and everything. And like you said, from the Walkmans to discs, and now everything's, you know, downloadable online and everything. And sound quality can be so good. It's like with the different speakers or headphones or whatever it might be that you're listening to it through, there's a ton of different ways to increase the quality of sound and everything. So the technology of music too has been one of those things that's jumped in leaps and bounds.
Yeah, I would definitely say. I think overall the means of communication have probably, for me, been the most kind of revolutionary. Because I remember when I was a kid, like, trying to, say, even play with a friend.
Right.
Like, how would you plan to play with a friend? You'd be like, hey, do you want to play football on Saturday?
Exactly.
And they'd be like, sure. And then you would somehow end up in the same place at the same time. And you wouldn't, like, you wouldn't have any, if they weren't there, it'd be like, well, weren't there. I can't contact him. Yeah, so what do I do?
Even for us, when we were growing up, you know, we always had a half hour drive, right?
Yeah.
So we were, you know, so far apart. But at the same time, you know, as technology advanced, that was able to close the gap between us. And we kind of talked about this a little bit in our last episode, but like just in video gaming and everything, and how we would have to go to each other's houses to play games with each other and stuff, right? Mm-hmm. But as technology advanced, and I think probably as we got into PC gaming more, that's when we were able to communicate online or even through phones and stuff. Once we got our own phones and stuff, we were able to contact each other through that. And then also just online, different ways, being able to communicate with each other and to play these games and stuff online. That's definitely one way that technology has completely changed our lives, you know?
And I would say now, as like currently where we're standing right now, technology is kind of probably going to be changing a little bit in the near future, because we've seen things like in the last year, even the rise and fall of Bitcoin and these different online currencies, as well as different technologies that are kind of changing the way that people think about, you know, money or, you know, work, how you can get jobs and how you can maintain jobs. And, you know, a lot of things are kind of switching from being managed in the real world to managed online. And I think in the coming, like, decade, it's going to be really interesting on, you know, how people are going to manage that. And it's going to be difficult for people who don't manage to kind of make that shift, because I think they're going to be missing out on a lot of the conveniences that come along with, you know, having everything digital, everything managed in one place. instead of, you know, multiple places.
Right. I think even where we're at right now is pretty amazing, just in comparison, you know. And so today's technology is really making some of the most advancements in electronics, because everything is being condensed and being made, you know, smaller. We can fit so much more technology into a smaller space now, you know, that we're able to come up with, you know, smaller computers like this, the laptop and everything, and it's able to get even better and better. And some of the ways I interact with technology now is just kind of like what we were talking about before, but it's so much more streamlined now and so much faster. You know, we have all this information now at the tips of our fingers right here on the computer and everything.
Yeah.
And that just was never made available to us before. You know, you'd have to go to libraries and stuff.
Yeah.
But now libraries are almost non-existent. You know, people don't really, you know, think about going to a library unless that's just something that they enjoy doing, you know, which is, you know, all
kind of weird. No kidding.
Yeah, I mean, it's almost becoming, you know, like this fossil in our history.
Yeah,
you know, these libraries.
But I mean, it is great for education as well. That's another thing that's probably going to be changing a lot. You know, in the last couple of years, a lot of sites like the Khan Academy, for example, have kind of taken its place in the forefront of education online, so that anybody can be educated.
Right, and Wikipedia, you know, rather than the best source of all, right?
Exactly. You know, nowadays, it's almost to the point where if you're passionate enough about something, it would be better for you to learn that on your own than go to college for that. Because in college, you know, you have to go through all these steps and go through these hoops to acquire your knowledge for a certain area. Yeah, and
some
a lot of money. So. You know, these are just some things that even right now are making a huge impact on the world. And of course, I think that technology is one of the few things that can kind of, you know, change these things. You know, you can't change these things through policies or through politics or business and stuff like that. You know, it's through technology that these things kind of change the world.
Right. Technology can definitely be used in so many different ways that, you know, we really hardly even scratch the surface of there yet, right?
I mean,
like you're saying with education and all this other stuff, and even just propelling your future in your profession or whatever it might be to make you so much better, you know, just being able to, even now in jobs, they can integrate, you know, these FaceTime, you know, chatting systems where you can basically have a meeting with people face-to-face, miles and miles apart from each other, right?
Yeah.
And even that's something that's pretty amazing. And even in our show that we're doing right here, right now, you know, we might not always be side-by-side, you know, each other. We might have to do some shows over the internet and stuff. So that's an awesome way that we can use technology just to basically stay connected, you know?
Yeah,
that's one of the most important parts, and I think staying connected with you guys is also something important that we want to emphasize here on this show. So if you guys have comments or questions or anything, any suggestions or anything, you can leave that, you know, in the YouTube spot below for comments and everything, or you can email us at Craic. TV@gmail.com. And if we can, you know, start a conversation between you guys and us and get to know you guys as well as you guys getting to know us, I think that's a great way for us to stay connected with each other and also provide more and better content for everybody.
Yeah,
and
definitely.
For all of us to have more fun with this, you know. And that's what Craic is all about. It's about having fun, interesting, entertaining conversation between everyone, you know, and so we want everybody to be involved. So thanks for watching, guys. Is there anything else you want to add to that real quick?
No, nothing that I want to add for this section. We're going to have another part after this.
Yeah.
That will be more in depth into a couple things that are happening today and a little bit about the future. So come back for that.
Yep.
And
stay tuned.
We'll see you guys once we upload it.
Yep. So. All right. Thanks for watching, guys.
See you guys.